get to the bed. Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah. We can clap hands for her. She's a gift in the body of Christ. Amen. I was complaining last night as we ascended the hill to pray. And I was saying, where is my daughter? She's the only one who hears a word from me in the mountain. All of these ones, they keep prophesying to one another and they never say a word to me. But this one says, Daddy, the Lord is saying this to you. Hallelujah. You blessed this morning. Allow me just to share a word very briefly. I hope I won't take much of your time. I just want us to go back to the scriptures where we read and just impress a few thoughts or a few words in 1 Chronicles chapter 15 and read a few verses in 1 Chronicles chapter 15. I'm just gonna jump a few verses. I'll juggle them around. Let me start by reading verse 1. Babeshabalala, you can interpret as I read. So if I read verse 1, you also read alongside. And David made him houses in the city of David and prepared a place for the ark of God and pitched a tent for it.
Emva kokuba David asadakhele indlu yakhe edolobheni laDavide, wabe sewulungisa indzawo ebeka ibhokisi lesivumelwano sikaNkulunkulu. Awuzimate wemisa ithempeli lekulifaka ekhansi.
Verse 16 says, and David spake to the chief of the Levites to appoint their brethren to be singers with instruments of music, psalteries, harps and cymbals, sounding by lifting up the voice with joy.
David watshela abaholi bemalebi ukuthi bakhethe bantu nebahlabeli ukuthi bathe uhlabela ingoma ngokujabula, baphekethelwa ngimtshingozi, emalire nemahabu kanye nemasimbani.
Verse 14 says, so the priest and the Levites sanctified themselves to bring up the ark of the Lord God of Israel.
Baphristi nemalevi batihlambulula ukuthi batewenyusa ibhokisi lesivumelwano sasimakathi uNkulunkulu wema-Israyeli.
Verse 12 to 15 says, and said unto them, ye are the chief of the fathers of the Levites, sanctify yourself, both ye and your children, that ye may bring up the ark of the Lord of God of Israel unto the place that I have prepared for it. For because ye did not as You did it not at the first, and the Lord our God made a breach upon us, for that we sought him not after the due order, mark the word order. So the priests and the Levites sanctified themselves to bring the ark of the Lord of God of Israel, and the children of the Levites bear the ark of God upon their shoulders with staffs thereon, as Moses commanded them to the word of the Lord.
Wakhuluma kubo wathi, nina nibaholi bemindeni yemalevi, nini nalamanye emalevi lekufanele nihlambulule nibe ngcwele, bese nilethele ibhokisi lesivumelwano sasimakathi uNkulunkulu wema-Israyeli, nilimikise kule ndzawo lengiyilungiselele lona. Kuma ube nini emalevi anilenyusanga kwekucala, ngakho-ke simakathe wasiphukuthelela ngaleso sikhathi. asizange sike sibute kusimakathi ukuthi singakwenda kanjani njengoba kubhaliwe. Ba priest nemalevi batihlambulula ukuthi batewele usadibhokisi lesivumelwano sangulunkulu uNkulunkulu wema Israyeli. Emalevi ethwala lelibhokisi lesivumelwano ngetimboko emahlombe awo njengoba Mosi abekhulumile ngekweminyango wasimakathi.
Verse 12 says, and it was told King David, saying, the Lord had blessed the house of Obed-Edom and all that pertained to him. I'm reading now 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 12. And it was told King David, saying, the Lord had blessed the house of Obed-Edom and all that pertained unto him because of the ark of God. So David went and brought the ark of the Lord from the house of Obed-Edom into the city of David with gladness.
Inkosi Davide bayitshela bathi simakaze sewuyibusisile indlu ya Obed-Edom kanye nako konke kwakhe ngenxa yebhokisi lesivumelwano sasimakaze. Ngakho Davide wasi uyehla uye ulandza ibhokisi lesivumelwano sangulunkulu ekhaya ka Obed-Edom, weta nalo waliletha eJerusalema lidolobha la Davide ahamba ajabula.
Hallelujah. Are you fine? We're going to read the word of God. Let's enjoy it. So that you understand the two scriptures in Chronicles and in 1 Samuel, I need to take you through the scripture in 2 Samuel chapter 6. So allow me to read from verse 1. I'll read one verse. Are you fine with that, Pastor Ron? Let's work the book so that we can understand. I don't want to just jump and stand on your feet without catching what was happening in this picture. Amen. So David again brought together all the able men. Now I want you to mark, it says again, all the able young men of Israel, 30,000 in number. And he and all his men went to Bala in Judah to bring up from there the ark of God, which is called by the name of the Lord Almighty, who is enthroned between the cherubims on the ark.
Davide waphinze wabutsela ndzawonye emadvodza elikhetselo aka-Israyeli labe 30,000 basawonke. Davide nawo onke lamadvodza labe wabutsile bashuca besuka eBhala lakaJuda kuyonyusa ibhokisi lesivumelwano sasimakathi. Khona lelitawubidwa ngelibido libido lasimakathi longisomandla lobusela esihlalweni sebukhosi asemkhathini wemakherubhi
They set the ark of God on a new cart and brought it from the house of Obed-Edom of Abinadab, which was on the hill. Uzzah and Ahio, sons of Abinadab, were guiding the new cart with the ark of God on it, and Ahio was walking in front of it. David and all Israel were celebrating with all their might before the Lord with castanets, harps, lyres, timbrels, sistrums, and cymbals.
Bakweta libhokisi lesivumelwano sangulunkulu enqoleni lensha balikhipha endlini yaka Abinadabu leyayisethulu entsabeni. Ukuza na-Ahiyo emadvodzana a-Abinadabu bashayela lenqola lensha leyayithwelele libhokisi lesivumelwano sangulunkulu. Ahiyo yena abelihambela embili. Davide nawe yonke indlu yaka-Israyeli babejabula bagitsa nawo onke emandla abo embi kwasimakathi bamdumisa ngetingoma kanye nangemahabhu nangemalire nangemafahlawane nangetikhelekehle nangemakhenkekhenke.
When they came to the threshing floor of Nacon, Uzzah reached out and took hold of the ark of God because the oxen stumbled. The Lord's anger burned against Uzzah because of his irrelevant act. Therefore, God struck him down and he died there besides the ark of God.
Bathi nabefika ebaleni lekubhulela lakanakhoni letingabi takhubadela ngabo uza welula sandla wabamba libhokisi lesivumelwano sangulunkulu. Lakalasimakadze lwamvutsela uza ngenxa yesento sakhe sekungahloniphi. Ngabo uNkulunkulu wamshaya wafa.
Then David was angry because the Lord's wrath had broken out against Uzzah, and to this day that place is called Perez Uzzah. David was afraid of the Lord that day and said, how can the ark of the Lord ever come to me? He was not willing to take the ark of the Lord to be with him in the city of David. Instead, he took it to the house of Obed-Edom the Gittite. The ark of the Lord remained in the house of Obed-Edom the Gittite for 3 months, and the Lord blessed him and his entire household.
Nalelolanga David wesaba simakazi wathi mathi wathi ngiyenda kanjani ibhokisi lesivumelwano kami nabo wangabe asavuma kulitsatsa ahambe nalo aye eJerusalem idolobha la David wabe sewuyaphambuka walimikisa ekhaya ka Obed Edom wasegathi libhokisi lesivumelwano sasimakazi lahlala ekhaya ka Obed Edom wasegathi inyanga letinsathu simakazi wambusisa Obed Edom kanye nayo yonke indlu yakhe.
Allow me this morning just to bring context to the two scriptures that we have read. There is a direct conjunction. These two scriptures, in order for you to understand the one in Chronicles, you must have an understanding of the scripture in the book of 2 Samuel chapter 6 we have just read. So I'm teaching about the protocols of carrying the presence of God. In the two scriptures, you will remember very well, children of God, that it has always been in the heart of God for God not to dwell in houses made with hands. God created Adam and Eve and placed him in the garden called Eden, which was the place of his presence. And the Bible says at the cool of every day, God would come down to Adam and he would fellowship with Adam. The fellowship between God and Adam had nothing to do with petition. Adam never left anything according to the word of God. Because when he was dwelling in the presence of God, the Bible says everything was in abundance in the presence of God. I believe that is the same reason why that caused David to write the scripture and say, in the presence of God there is fullness. So God never came to Eden at the cool of the day to hear problems and requests from Adam. So you must be careful as a child of God that whenever you approach God, heaven must not know, but see, when I see so and so, say, Shila Gapets, I call up from the blooms of God. The heavens must get used to you too. You must come before the presence of the Lord primarily for fellowship. Once you understand the protocols of his presence, you will spend less time doing petitions than asking before God. So when men fell into sin, sin separated men from the presence of the Lord. We are told in the book of Exodus, I remember chapter 25, where God made the garments of the priest and told Moses to build a tabernacle. The sole purpose of building the tabernacle was to house the presence of God. It was to house the presence of God. And God gave very strict dimensions on how the tabernacle must be built. God gave Moses the blueprint of how to build the tabernacle. Every time they were building, Moses would go and refer to the blueprint of the Ark of Covenant.
Moses Abraham, aya ushola le plan na beganike toyona yesivumelwano.
When God came to supervise,
ngulungulu nakete tawuhola
the building of the tabernacle.
Lokwakhiwa kwetabernacle.
Once the tabernacle was built according to the pattern shown by God.
Nangabela kiwe ngendlela ebeyikhonjiswa uNkulunkulu elithabanakele.
Ah, you don't bring the presence anyhow, children.
Awubulethi sinome kanjani lokukhona.
There are protocols that must be followed to bring the presence.
Kune indlela letilandzelwa ukuletha lokukhona.
Creativity is not allowed when it's when you deal with issues and protocols of the presence of God.
Akungavumeleki ukuthi ukhombise ngihlakanipha kwakho nawusebukhoneni baNkulunkulu.
You can't create your own way of approaching the presence of God.
Akhela watakhela tindlela takho tebuye ebukhoneni baNkulunkulu.
The Bible says when the last peg was hit on the building.
The Bible lithi nangabe kushayelwa bebili peg lekugcina kule sakhiwo.
The Shekinah presence of God fell on that tabernacle.
Lobukhona baNkulunkulu behlela kule tabernacle.
When the glory came upon the tabernacle.
Ingathi mlona yehlela yethu kwale tabernacle.
The glory was coming to confirm that the patterns have been kept.
Lekathi mlona beyithelekta uqinisekisa ukuthi shitila ukuthi letindlela tilandzelwe takhi.
Whenever we are worshiping,
nangabe sikhona abandla
kaNkulunkulu. And the presence of God comes in that church.
Wehle kukhona baNkulunkulu kulelo
kwabo. That mountain or house where you are praying.
Noma ke kule yondlu noma intaba lothandana.
You must know it is a proof that the patterns have been kept.
Ubika uponde ukuthi indlela tilandzelwe.
God does not appear anywhere.
NkuluNkulunkulu akabheli noma ngabe
ngubani. It does not appear everywhere.
Akabheli yonke indzana.
Ah, pastor, why are you saying God doesn't appear anywhere? Does the Bible not say that God is omnipresent?
Sokuthini mfundisi iBhayibheli alisho ukuthi uNkulunkulu ukhona indzawo
yonke. Yes, God is omnipresent.
Yebo ukhona konke
indzawo. When you go to the mountain you find God.
Noma uyethe intabeni utamthola.
When you go to the valley you find God.
Noma uyethe godzini utamthola.
Under the sea you will find God.
Noma uyenondle utamthola.
But that is the omnipresence of God.
Ngicela ukukhona baNkulunkulu indzawo yonke.
Is the first level of the presence.
Izinga lekuqala lekhona
baNkulunkulu. This is what we call the Emmanuel presence of God.
Kunelizinga laNkulunkulu lokuthiwa Emmanuel.
Where the Bible says where two or three are gathered then I will be in the midst.
Lalithi iBhayibheli nangabe lababili labathathu behlangene sikaba semkhathini.
That is the God in us.
NkuluNkulunkulu lokuthi.
So even when we come to worship God on a Sunday.
Noma utheta ukhona uNkulunkulu ngeso.
We experience the Emmanuel presence of God.
Uhlangana ke nalokho kukhona baNkulunkulu lokuthiwa
Emmanuel. The omnipresence of God.
Uhlanganele nalokukhona baNkulunkulu endzaweni yonke.
But there is a higher dimension to those two dimensions.
Ekhamezinga leliphakeme kwedlula letindlela letindlu.
It is called the kabod, the Shekinah presence of God.
Kuthiwa ikabod noma ke iShekinah presence yaNkulunkulu.
It is the weight of Jehovah.
Isisindo saJehovah.
And that weight does not appear everywhere at any time.
Lesisindo leso asiveli noma ngabe ngikuphi noma ngabe.
The weight will come to confirm that the patterns
lesisibo sela kaqinisekisa ukuthi indlela dilandzele.
Somebody following me this
corner inomba ke say.
So they build and the glory of God came down.
Bakha indatimlo yaNkulunkulu yehla.
Oh, it came down on the wilderness.
Yehla ehla.
Where they were.
Labe basebenza
kuwo. God, it doesn't matter.
Akunenza
where you are worshiping God.
Uthi mkhona kuphi uNkulunkulu?
You can worship God in a kumbi.
Ungamkhona ekumbini.
When the patterns are kept.
Nangabe indlela tigcinile.
The glory of God can manifest.
Ngakuphi uNkulunkulu ngabonana?
You can worship God in your house.
Ungamkhona endlini.
When the patterns are kept.
Nangabe indlela tilandile.
The glory can manifest.
Ngakuphi uNkulunkulu ngabonana?
You might not be in church.
Ungena ungabise sontweni.
But when the patterns are present.
Etha nangabe ugcinele indlela.
The glory can manifest. So the Bible says, Israel traveled from Canaan from Egypt to Canaan.
Baka Israel basuka eGibhithe baye Canaan.
They were fully provided for. They were blessed by God.
Babusisiwe uNkulunkulu.
Let's go out and come in.
Babusisiwe bangena, babusisiwe babuphuma.
What was the secret of their blessing?
Dakuyini imfihlo yesibusiso
sabo. It was the ark of God. Which was the main manifest presence of God.
Ebubu kwenziwa ukubonakala kwaNkulunkulu.
I'm trying not to go to the details of the tabernacle. But allow me this morning not to go to those details. Because right inside the tabernacle that Moses built, there was fire in the outer court. There was fire in the inner court. And there was fire in the holy of holies. There was fire everywhere. Fire in the mountain. Fire in the outer court. Fire in the inner court. Fire in the holy of holies. But the fire in the outer court and the inner court, it was a man-made fire that was crafted by the priests. The priests were the ones that were making the fire. So that when they serve in the tabernacle, they don't serve in a fireless tabernacle. According to the pattern of Jehovah, it is wrong for people to serve in the house of God when there is no fire. When there is no fire. The reason why God gave Hannah to give birth to
Samuel,
it was not because God wanted to please Hannah
per se.
God was fulfilling what he wanted to do, but using Hannah as a conduit. As long as Hannah was praying for God to give him a son, in order to compete with
Penina,
God said, I know you want a son, but I don't give sons just to prove a point.
It is
a practice that happened in the body of Christ. I want a car because so and so bought a car. I
want to
get married because so and so is getting married. No child of God. God always fulfills his own purpose. How will what you want from God? How will what you desire from God? How will what you want from God? How is it going to serve God's purpose? That must be the bottom question. Oh, I received a word. I was coming to church this morning. I received a word that said a son was frustrated this morning in church about finding a job. God said, I must tell you not to worry anymore. I
always
go. So the Bible says,
I believe
Hannah, what caused God to give Hannah a son called
Samuel
was because Eli was now an old man. He was unable to ensure that the fire is always burning in the outer court and the inner court. When Hannah realized that, she changed her prayer request. I pray in this season,
Bazaar.
And even as I'm preaching now,
that
some of you must change your prayer request. The reason why you are not getting what you are asking is because you want it for yourself. Listen to how Hannah prayed. Hannah said, Lord, if you give me a son, I will give him back to you. The Bible says, God said, what? You're
going
to give it back to me. In other words, he was saying, the marriage that you are giving me, the marriage you are going to give me, or the car that I want, or the house that I want, I'm going to give it back to you. God said, what are you saying? My kingdom purposes. And the Bible says God then gave Hannah again Samuel. The whole purpose of
Samuel
was to light and make sure there is fire in the house. I do not know what Samuel you desire. desire.
Angathi ukuthi ngubu Samuel ufuna.
What Samuel you desire?
Angathi Samuel ufuna.
I have a question for you.
Ipande kubuto.
How will the Samuel you desire?
Lo Samuel ufuna.
Benefit the house of God.
Ngathi kuzwa kanjani indabulo kuwo?
Sometimes we don't get what we want.
Chana siyakhatha siphulile sifuna ngoNkulunkulu.
Not because God can give it.
Hayi ngoba uNkulunkulu akakhona ukupha.
But it is the motivation we have behind what we want from God.
Since that uletibo letiphuba ukuze uyawufuna lo ufuna ngoNkulunkulu.
So there was a fire in the altar called the inner court.
Ile ndawo yale phandle lasenza
ukuthi required men to build it.
Jaba uthina umuntu
ukuthi the Holy of Holies.
Ephandle wendwe lengwe.
The Bible says.
Bible says
the fire that was there.
Lo mlilo lobe ukhona la.
Was not built by anyone.
Lo wakhiwa ba.
Even Moses.
Na Moses
did not put that fire.
Akangaka upasi lo mlilo.
There was a blue flame.
Ndakona mlilo lo mhla.
Sitting on the mercy seat.
Ndaba ukhulekeza wena engwe.
Between the cherubs.
Ema cherub.
That were facing one another.
Ndakona buke.
When the people, the worshippers were worshiping.
Na ndakona tikoni tikhona.
They did not worship facing the people.
But no kodi tibukela ba.
But they were worshiping, they were worshiping facing the presence of God.
Ndakona ndakona kodi ababuke khona bangulu.
They are so worried.
I ukhathazeka
ba. The reaction of the people.
Ndakona ukuthi bantu bathi.
They are so worried.
Ndakona ukhathazeka.
The Christ was still there.
Ndakona ukuthi sekhona indomini.
Because when they saw the light.
Ngoba ndababona lo
mini. They knew God is in our midst.
Ndakona ukuthi bulu
ukuthi sakhathazeka. They left him. Whether you believe it or not,
no, we are calling about
whether you receive the blessing or not.
Who
is a blesser even if he has not performed? So he took the ark into the battlefield. They whipped them and they killed so many people. And the Philistines, they took the ark and took it to their seat. The Philistines are worshipping God, the God called Dagon. When they reach their place, they try to put our God, the presence of God, in the midst of other gods. When they woke up in the morning, Dagon had fell on his face. Because our God, doing church.
Mahamba so.
Worshiping God.
Makwanda mulungu.
Preaching.
Mayesuma.
When their presence is not there.
Makwanda mulungu.
The church sometimes has become an ikapot.
Iba dani sati nasi nami ni meni kapot.
Serving God.
Makwanda mulungu.
Without His presence.
Makwanda wakwanda ba.
So in the scripture where we are.
Makwanda sputse ko.
David is making means.
Makwanda uzama meta.
To bring back the ark.
Kepuisa lompongo.
To its place.
Makwanda nenda wenyang.
So the first attempt. We will look at the first attempt. And then look at the second attempt. When he first attempted to bring the presence of God, he sent men.
30,000
men. To bring the ark.
Who talented on Pomo?
God is concerned with quality. More than quantity. You will hear me next year. There were 30,000 in number. Trying to bring the presence. They then built a cart. And put the presence of God in the cart. And they walked in front of the ark.
Uzza
had lived with the ark of God for many years until he became familiar with the presence of God. It is dangerous, children of God, to get familiar with the presence of God. Even the angels in heaven, they live in the Shekinah glory. They see a different aspect of God. They can't get familiar to God. They bow and say, holy. They say, your blessings and joys forever. They never get used to Jehovah. You see, once you have kept used to God, it is difficult to even get on your knees at the angels. And try holy. Your blessings and joys forever. Approach Jehovah. You must never get familiar with Jehovah. When God says we are going on the ground, say, Father, I'm willing to go to the ground. When God says we are lying on the carpet, say, Father, I'm willing. I don't want to get used to the presence. I don't want to get familiar with God. The Bible says that they carried the ark, they passed through the threshing floor, and the Bible says they were the bomb that hit the ark. And the ark, when the ark was tilted to fall, Uzza, because of familiarity, he tried to assist God. He was struck and he died. Child of God, you try to assist your
God.
Sometimes, in church, as we are worshiping, we can feel that there is a discord in what we are singing. We practice so well on Friday, but when we are singing on Sunday, we feel like there is a discord.
But
try to help God. It is God by Himself. It is the
order
and the finish of the service. It is the owner of the worship service. Try to worship Him.
David was so afraid
that he took the ark no longer taking this thing to my city. He took it to the house of Obed-Edom. The Bible says, it stayed there for 3 months. When it was there, wherever there is a presence, there becomes revival. When the presence of God was in the house of Obed-Edom, if there was drought, when the presence came in, the Bible says, the Lord blessed Obed-Edom. Why Obed-Edom? Because the presence is standing in the house of Obed-Edom. Child of God, don't seek for provision. Don't seek for many things. Seek the presence. As you hold the presence, you have a blessing upon your life. The things that you want from Jehovah, you can receive from the Lord. Just learn the protocol of hosting the presence. The protocols of visiting the present. No. It's the protocol of hosting the presence. Whether it's in January, whether it's in June, whether it's in March, you must be the carrier of the presence of God. Understand the protocol of hosting the presence. And let me say 5 things and sit down. Number 1, what did David do to host the presence? After the first attempt failed, he then built a tent for the presence. I want you to mark. He did not build a house. He built a tent. And this tent had no apartments. No partitions. It was one big tent. The tent was a typology of our generation. Because Paul says, don't you know that the Lord is the temple of God? He says, don't you know that when
when this body is taken down,
which means the body is the tent. So when David built the tent, he was pointing to us that there is a generation that will carry the ark inside their tent. They carry both the ark in the tent. The tent is not permanent. The tent is not a house. So we are carrying it in a tent. As long as we are still this side. But when we transit to the other side, we will worship Him in His presence. No longer in a tent. But we will sit permanently in the place of the glory. As long as you are still alive, you must carry the presence. It is wrong for you, child of God, to be alive and not be a host of the presence of God. No wonder staff are dying left, right, and center in your life. There is drought. There is no breakthrough. I ask you and charge you today. Are you the carrier of the presence of God? Have you prepared yourself to host Him? Just imagine if they would say, not even King
Mswati.
If they would say, two of King Mswati's wives are coming to worship in this house. You can imagine the preparations that can be done to make sure that when they arrive, the house is in order. Not even His Majesty, but His wife. And you, child child of God, you are a host of the King of Kings. But there is no preparation to host the presence of God. What have you put out of your house? What have you put inside your house? Have you built a throne for the presence to see? But you know, children of God, that even King Himself, when he wants to sign anything into law, if he is in Nhlangano, the cabinet will go to Nhlangano.
They
will speak to him and say, "Oh, Your Majesty, we want to pass this ancient law. But to sign it into law, he will drive in the night from Nhlangano and come to Lusitasis and sit on the throne and legislate from the throne. Because the king cannot legislate from any other place. I charge you today, have you built a throne in the inside of you for the king to come and sit on his throne?
So that they don't stink
or rot. So anyone who's a member of the priesthood was supposed to be embalmed with anointing oil. No man was allowed to carry the presence of God while they are still alive. So God will kill them even before they start to serve Him. No man will stand on the altar while they still remember their name, their surname, and their position. God will kill all that in your life before you can serve as a priest. That's why in this day, when people are not concentrated in the priesthood, the pulpit is a stage and not an altar. You sing very well, but we can see too much of you in the song.
At work where you work,
when you hear the I was not born in a home where there is a father. I was raised by a single parent. Gave me one rule or one umiyalo my whole life that I can't remember. He said, my child, never be in a corner. So one day I would visit other people's families.
The selection park.
Me having grown up and raised by a single mother. In our house, every chair is a chair.
So let's do not get a stool.
But when I started to live with Ramcha, I tried to sit in a chair facing the television. They told me move away from the chair.
Then
what's wrong with the chair?
They say this is Mr. Mchali's chair.
When Mchali walks into the room, he must find the chair empty. And they must hand over the remote control to him. Women, you people don't respect us, the Makaya. When I enter the house, Mama, I'm going to see little. So why did they do that? I went to the kitchen. I tried to put some sour porridge into a dish. They said to me, you can use that one and that one, but you can't use this one. I said, why? It's just an ordinary dish. They say, this is Balmjali's dish. I learned the principle that is in the word of God. The chair, the spoon, and the dishes were sanctified for the use of Balmjali on. So when God said the Levites and the priests must sanctify themselves, it means their lives must be set apart for only God to use. No one must use your life except to be used by Jehovah. No witch doctor, no one must use this body. David in the book of 1 Chronicles 15 from verse 12 to 15. He restored the order that God had set through Moses. It was a requirement that the priests and the Levites would carry the ark in their shoulders. David had broken protocol by using a cart to carry the presence. The presence of God must sit on the shoulders of men and women in the church. We must become so priestly in the church that when you enter the church, we must sense that you are carrying the ark. I know some people in church that pick up the microphone and you can sense, I'm not trying to No! We don't want that. When you pick up the microphone, we must sense there is something healthy sitting on top of you. As you pass the soul and give glory to God, we must sense the weight of the presence. When you see us falling on our feet, we are not falling because of you. We Positions.
You've always been faithful.